has some couple little rules that you need to know from the get-go. Number one, you don't need any pencils, paper, nothing. Everything we're doing is going to be mental. It's going to be one thing. Number two, no talking necessary, and we have a special way of indicating that you're done. Instead of raising your hand, we use thumbs. So the idea is you want to hide it. You don't want anybody to see your hand up because they get distracted. You just want them to be able to sit and think, you got an answer? You raise your thumb like that. You've got two strategies to get an answer? Do this. Three, you get the picture. So I'm just going to put up a problem. You guys are just going to work quietly. Once you have a strategy how to answer this problem, give me a thumbs up. But keep it subtle. All right. So the question is, which is bigger? Your options are 75 times 29 or 79 times 25. Nobody is writing anything down. You're doing this all in your head before you get started. Can I get an estimation? Who thinks, by show of hands, 75 times 29 is going to be bigger? Who thinks 79 times 25 is going to be bigger? Okay, we've got a couple people. All right. So you guys just go ahead, go to it. Just be silent. Once you think you have an answer, give me a thumbs up. If you have two different strategies to get there, give me another finger. Just take your time. Thumbs up. I'm happy to give you guys more time. Hit the button. You guys want a couple more minutes? No? Okay. So I've seen some thumbs up. Who thinks that 75 times 29 is going to be bigger? Raise your hand. All right. Who thinks 79 times 25 is going to be bigger? All right. Excellent. I've got options. So I saw some 75 times 29 over here. Who raised your hands again? What's your name? I'm just going to put your name down right now. I'm going to come back yet. Who else is over here? What's your name?
Sam.
And if I could have one more, please.
Preston.
Awesome. Okay. For those who thought 79 times 25 was bigger, could you raise your hands again? What's your name? One more person. You had your hand.
No,
can you explain a strategy that you had? From this one, I mean. It's okay if you don't have to. Does anybody else have a strategy for this one? Okay, let's just start with Cooper. Would you mind explaining? And you can just tell me, and I'm going to write what you think is awesome.
So, first I broke it up into 70 times 20.
70 times 20. Okay.
And so then I did the math on that, and then I got 1,400.
Okay.
And then I did 5 times 9.
5 times 9. Okay.
I got 45.
All right.
And then added the 2.
And you added the 2. this one? Oh, wait, so you thought that that was bigger than this one, right?
Yeah.
Why?
Well,
did you have a similar way of...
At the moment, I thought it was 75 times 29, then 75 times 25, so I thought it was obvious, but I didn't really catch it, so...
Okay. Oh, so you're saying you didn't quite see the
problem? I
didn't quite
read the
problem. Gotcha. Okay, that's fine, that's fine. Well, thank you for sharing your strategy anyway. I appreciate that. Okay, so can you tell me exactly what you did? Guys are working on this distributed property right now, right? So if I could just show something, there's lots of different ways to look at this. But if we make a rectangle, like this, and I want to think about area. So if I make this side of the rectangle 29 and this side of the rectangle 75, I just wanted to point something out. So if I've broken it up like this, 70 times 20, and then 5 times 9, I've got 70 up to here, so this length is 5, this length is 70, and so this here times 20, this is 29, this length is 9, this length is 20. So this area in this box right here that I've calculated is 70 by 20. Now can somebody see a 5 by 9 box in this same figure?
If you draw a line down between a 5, oh,
right there. This guy. So when I added these together, did I miss anything?
Yes, you missed
it. So I miss all of this. I miss 5 times 20. And it's 70 times 9. So that's one way. There's lots of other ways to look at this. I don't want to take up too much more of your time, But you guys are also doing factoring. So one way that maybe is kind of easy that I saw that nobody really mentioned was factoring. So how can I factor 75 into something that might look like that? Sir?
25 times 3.
So I could say this is actually 25 times 3 times 29. And now what do I have over here? This is 25 times 79. Can anybody see a way for me to, sir?
Well, I just figured, like, if you had, like, 75 times 25, and then, like, 29 is 4 more than 25, but the four times is going to 75, so that's like an extra 4 times 75. As for the other one, that's an extra 4 added on to the 75, so that's just an extra 4 times 25, so 75 times 29 would be bigger.
75 times 29 would be bigger than... What is 29 times 3?
87.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the same thing as saying 25 times 87. There are actually lots of different cool ways to look at this. This is one of the neatest. And one of the easiest ways is to factor, which is something that's been... So how would you prove to me that those two are equal? Use a calculator. What about rounding and estimating? What do you think?
Oh, well, you could just, I think what James said, well, you could just make them both 75 times 25, and then just you have 4 left over from the 29, so it'd be 75 times 4. And then on the other side, it'd be 25 times 4. 75 times 4 is more than 25 times 4.
So I'm sorry, you have both 75 times 25.
Yeah, and then what would be left is 75 times 4 and then 25 times 4. And 75 times 4 is more than 25 times 4. Also the other one.
So you can see that these two here are the same. This is clearly greater than that. So it's a way to show it. There's lots of different ways to think about this, you guys, and I'm really happy you let me come up here and do this. And hopefully we'll have some more time later on to do some more number talks. Thank you so much.